I'm Deshaun.
And I'm DeMondre.
And this is our project on metabolism. First, we'll be looking at the understandings of metabolism. The metabolic pathways consist of changes in cycles of enzymes catalyze reactions.
Enzymes lower the activation energy of chemical reactions that are catalyzed.
Enzyme inhibitors can be competitive or non-competitive.
Metabolic pathways can be controlled by end product inhibition.
The application of metabolism. End product inhibition of the pathways that convert theraline or that word. Acetylene, I'm gonna guess. At this point.
Use some databases to identify. Use of databases to identify the potential new antimalarial drugs.
Core content. We're going to talk about metabolic pathways, activation energy, enzyme inhibitors, feedback inhibitors, enzyme kinetics, and rational drug design.
Now, first off, we have the metabolic pathways. So, metabolic pathways can be controlled by the end product inhibition of the pathway, also known as feedback inhibition. So, as you see in this little graph down here, we have a chain and also a cycle. And right where these arrows are, that is where the enzymes be getting this, I guess you could call it a species. And as it goes higher, it is increasing in the thing. And the same thing with the cycle. You can go to the next slide. And here we have the activation energy of the metabolism. So here, the activation energy is essentially how the species gets its energy, that way it can react to certain things. The energy is required to start a reaction. Enzymes and proteins are bound together to a molecule or a substrate. Doing this allows the energy to make the species react. And you see in this graph right here, and the tallest one is with when the species is without enzyme. And the bottom is just when the species does have an enzyme. Other stuff right here, but in this one with this man and this blue ball, big one at the top, he's going up the hill, but it shows how the struggle of him trying to push the ball up the hill because he's without enzymes, then when the guy at the bottom does have enzymes and he's, you know, it's easier for him to push the ball up the hill.
Enzymes inhibitors. So first, for an enzyme is used to catalyze the reaction within a substrate. So a substrate would attach itself to the enzyme's active site so it can speed up the reaction and reduce the things needed to go through with that reaction. And so there are two things that disrupt this process, and one's called a competitive inhibitor. The second one is non-competitive. The competitive inhibitor attaches directly to the active site. Right here. This is the competitive inhibitor. It's stopping this substrate from attaching to the active site. And that directly interferes with the catalyzation of the substrate. And then you have your non-competitive inhibitor. Your non-competitive inhibitor, the C, does not attached to the active site. It attaches down here at an alternative space. And what this does is it changes the shape of the active site so that this substrate may no longer attach to it correctly. Because you see, a substrate and the active site have the same structure. And with what this non-competitive inhibitor does is it changes that shape, and so the substrate is no longer to attached to the active site. Feedback inhibition. So, feedback inhibition is also called the end product inhibition. And so what this does is, it basically, it's like a balancer. So when too much is being produced, this thing comes in and it starts taking up space so that less is being produced, less energy is being produced. And also, if there's too little being produced, these things will move a step back and allow the energy to be produced.
Enzyme kinetics. The rate of an enzyme is catalyst reaction. The rate of an enzyme catalyst reaction can be calculated and plotted according to the time taken for the reaction to proceed. The time taken can be measured according to either the amount of product formed or the amount of substrate consumed. Reaction rate is the inverse of time taken, meaning that the reaction rate is either higher when less time is taken, and vice versa. Rational drug design. The maturation and development of the parasite in both human and mosquito hosts is coordinated by specific enzymes. By targeting these enzymes for inhibition, new anti-malarial drugs and medications can be produced. From the proteome, enzymes involved in parasitic metabolism have been identified as potential targets for inhibition. These enzymes may be screened against a bioinformatic database of chemicals to identify potential enzyme inhibitors. Once the promising compound is identified, it may be chemically modified to improve its binding affinity and lower its toxicity, as this flow chart I provided shows why. In one particular study, over 300 chemicals were screened to identify 19 new chemicals that might function as inhibitors. As you look at this flowchart, as you see in this flowchart, we have compound collections. These compound collections turn into primary assays, high throughout in vitro. After the primary, they turn into secondary assays, and this is their efficiency, their toxicity, and their bioavailability decrease. This is where our antibiotics come from, our vaccines. After this process, they either turn into a prime candidate drug, or if they need more workings or whatever, scientists, lead compounds and SAR. And this directly turns it into a structural characterization of protein, which then goes into chemical synthesis.
So you may have asked why we were working out in the beginning of our video, or, you know, just fooling around, exercising. The reason why we were doing that, it was just to show that our bodies need that jump start for the enzymes to be flowing and give us that energy boost that we need for our metabolism to be right.